If you're looking for faster analysis of your Softr data, look no further than this video, because the newest feature from Softr allows us to incorporate AI agents right into our database. So if learning more about this great new feature is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools, and Softr is one of those tools that we talk about all the time here on this channel. Now, before we get into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to follow along with me. If you are not already a paying Softr customer, we can get you 1 month free on the Pro plan at Softr if you sign up using our promo code that you see on the screen right now. Follow the steps here on the screen to put that code in so that you can get 1 month free. It's over $100 value, quite a great little promo from Softr, so make sure to take advantage of that. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and I'm gonna show you where we're gonna build our AI agents. I've already got a couple here. Now, first things first, we are in the databases inside of Softr. So if you're not really comfortable with these databases yet, because they're a newer feature, when you've logged into Softr, first you're gonna see all of your apps. This is kind of the default view. You can then on the left-hand side, click on your databases. And this is going to be where you can create databases for your different Softr apps. And in this case, I've created a new database that is not yet titled. And the idea here is that we're collecting customer feedback for this example. So you can see here that we've got 10 different people who've submitted feedback, and this could be in a Softr form, you know, maybe they are chatting with a chatbot in our app, something like that, but we're collecting this feedback and we want to perform some kind of analysis. We need to know, how are we doing in general? What kind of feedback are we collecting? Let's get a summary of that information. And probably most importantly, what's next? Are we going to follow up with these folks? Do we need to take some kind of action, or are we just sitting on this information for now? So let's take a look at the different things that we've collected from our customers. So we can expand this field and of course make this visible in our app, but you can see all the different components that are right here. Now, if we had to assign somebody to manually go through and read every piece of feedback and assign, you know, the sentiment and summarize it and all of that, it's a huge waste of labor cost, right? We can do this more easily, more efficiently with AI agents. And so very simply, we've already built two different agents here, and we're gonna build a third one live in the video so that you can watch step by step how it comes together and how fast it is. So number one, we built a categorization. We wanna categorize the information here as either negative, positive, or neutral. So how do we do that? Well, this is a single select type, right? It's the select field type. This represents the type of data, but what it is, it's an AI field. And we have toggled on here that AI gets to autofill this field. And we can alternatively add additional manual edits. So when we hover over here, as you can tell, we get to now enable this option to allow the field to either be edited manually or by automations in addition to being filled by the AI. So sometimes you might want the AI to have exclusive writing permissions to that particular field. In other use cases, you might want to allow people to come in after the fact and then edit that information or edit that information from an automated workflow as well. So if you want that, make sure to toggle this on. But we're going to say, hey, look, this is an AI field only. So no trouble there. We also get to choose our model, and you can see that Softr has put out for us the cost, the relative cost of the models. So I just went with the default model here, GPT 4.1, but you can see that there are some cheaper models that we can use and some more expensive models. So go through and read up on the different models to determine which one you want to use for your app analysis and AI agents. So I'm going to stick with GPT 4.1. And now for the prompt. The secret sauce is always in the prompts when we're dealing with AI agents. The more specific, the more information you can put in your prompt, the better outcomes you're going to get. Our prompts are fairly straightforward, fairly simple, but if you're writing more advanced AI agents, make sure to spend more time here on the prompts to include all of the fringe use cases that you need to reference. But for us, we just want to look at the customer feedback information. Assuming that this stuff, of course, is what we get from our form, we want to analyze this field, customer feedback, and we want to provide the sentiment, right? So you can see we've gone with a template here, which we can access just like this by saying summarize text. And we plugged in that template prompt, categorize the content into one of the predefined options in the current field. Now, where do we get those predefined options? Remember, this is a select field, not a text field. So we want to go over to define those options in our settings, and this is where we can build out the different types or the options for us, positive, neutral, and negative. We can also change the colors here, and we get full control over the hex code of the color that we want to choose. We can also allow multi-select or add a default option, which we don't want for our AI agent. Now, a couple of more advanced features as well. We can toggle on the ability to enable web search. So this is not really relevant for our use case, but let's say we wanted to write a biography for people that were in a CRM database. We could go crawl the web and pull back a web search so that we could pull a biography or compose a biography based on what we find using people's email addresses or their full names and go out and really conduct a search about who they are. We can also do a run when. Now, I like this one because we could say this is manually triggered. We might set up rules that say, hey, when a new record is created, that's when we're going to do it. And we can also apply some kind of filters here. So let's say, for example, we only wanted to have our AI agent run under very specific conditions. Maybe we only want to perform an analysis or a summary only under the condition where the sentiment of the feedback is negative. Well, we could set up a rule for another AI agent to look first at this one and say, only if it's negative do we want to run the next agent. And this way we can chain a bunch of agents together and make sure that we're not using our AI credits without intent. Obviously, when using AI, we want to limit the use to when we really want to do it. And so this filter really allows us to do that, to only run under specific conditions. So there we go. We can save this up. And you see we got those outputs already created. Now, similar thing here with our brief summary. It's a different type of data. So the field type is a short type. We, of course, have no real settings here other than a default value. So nothing much to look at here. But on the AI side of things, we're saying create a brief summary of the feedback. And again, note that we've been able to reference other fields in our Softr database. In this case, we're referencing the customer feedback field. And we have all the other features as well. Manual edits, run it under certain conditions. And of course, we could also do a quick preview here if we wanted to see. Let's say we wanted to see the summary for John. Let's bring in John's feedback. We can run it, get that preview to make sure that the prompt is doing kind of what we expect it to do. And we also see what the cost in AI credits is going to be for us when we run this. So that's it. Let's now build another AI agent field here, and we're going to focus on what follow-up steps should we be taking. So let's imagine that we want to do a select field, either yes or no, do we need follow-up? So we can just call this follow-up needed, ? And we'll choose the field type to be a select field. So here we can set it up and say determine if follow-up is needed for the feedback shared here. And we can bring in that at reference. Now, in order to get this pulled up, I just typed the at symbol on my keyboard. Alternatively, I can click down here to bring this up, and we can now select the customer feedback. Now, I need to give it options because this is a single select. So let's head to our settings, and we're going to have a yes, feedback needed. And we're going to have a no, no feedback required. Those are my options. Let's set it to work. I'm going to save it. You'll notice that we've got that little star here, which means this is an AI agent. And in order to get these going, let's start hitting that play button here. and we're gonna run them, and we're seeing that one of the two outputs is always being brought in, yes or no, either feedback required or no, no feedback required. So now let's build one more agent, and this time we'll use a short text, and this will be feedback steps. And we can simply say something like, provide a list of next steps for feedback on this customer note. And let's bring in their customer information. All right, so this is a next steps for what we are gonna do. And it's not the best prompt I ever wrote in my life, but we're gonna go with it here. And let's set up our conditions here. We're gonna run under specific conditions. We'll apply the condition that we only wanna do this if the follow-up needed is yes, feedback required, right? So we've got that. We'll skip the value if it already exists. Now, before we test this out, we might do one additional thing and say, we only wanna update this if there is a change to the customer feedback field. And we can also bring in, of course, the follow-up needed field. So if there's a change to either of those fields, then that is where we want to actually initiate this, this AI agent. So let's go ahead and save those changes here. And let's make a quick change to this one. And I'll just add an extra question mark here because that should trigger our AI agent. Because when the change is made to this field, that is going to then set up the rules and essentially give us our feedback steps, which we can see here if we pop this open, verify the customer's email address, check the onboarding email delivery. I mean, look at that. It gave us a list of things to do. Now, what happens if I make an edit to one of these where there is no feedback required? Let me add a couple of periods here. You'll notice that we don't see the AI agent running here because of the fact that the follow-up needed is still no. And that way, we're not wasting those AI credits on stuff that we don't want to spend them on. So, a lot of new potential with AI agents inside of Softr databases. Remember, Softr databases allow your Softr apps to load that much more quickly by storing the data directly there. So we are loving the new database feature from Softr, and now it's been made even more robust thanks to these AI agents. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If you did, we'd love it if you could give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. If you have questions we did not get to, feel free to swing by our website because we've put a ton of resources together for you there. But most importantly, my friend, keep on building.